everybody. Welcome to Jenny Fit Start, your go-to channel for active seniors and beginners. All right, y'all, you have made it to day two. Woot! I'm excited for y'all. Today is going to be arm strengthening. We're going to get some beautiful biceps, some beautiful triceps, some beautiful shoulders. Easy to follow. Modify when you need to. All you need is a pair of hand weights. If you don't have hand weights, grab two soup cans or two water bottles. Those will work too. Now, make sure you subscribe to my channel because tomorrow I'm going to upload a day three video. We're doing a 7-day series and I want you to follow along with me the whole week. 30 minutes a day, that's all. And it's free. You got this. But make sure you subscribe so that you get a notification when I upload it, all right? So grab your weights and let's go. All right, everybody, let's get started. We're gonna warm up those arms because that's what we're working on. Up and back, up and back. Let's just make sure our bodies are nice and warm so that we can help prevent injuries and that we can get to our full range of motion. Now in and out, take it in and out. Good. Cross the arms and then bring them behind the body if you can. Out, pull, good. Beautiful, now arms out. Little circles, that's it. Let's get those shoulders ready. Now backwards. Beautiful. You got it. Now let's take your wrist. Circles, that's it. Other way, good. That's it, that's it. Now last thing, arms up, let's take it, reach, 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 good. Couple more, four, three, two, and one. Arms up tall. And shake it out. All right, how do they feel? Are you ready to get some strengthening in? Grab a pair of hand weights. Mine are sixes, but I vary mine all the time. You may have a couple of pair of weights that you wanna go back and forth with. That would be fine too. All right, we're gonna start with the bicep muscle. That is this muscle. We need it all the time. We use it all the time. Give me a hammer grip. They're relatively strong muscles because we use them a lot. They're mainly used for pulling muscles. Good, these are single biceps. Give me another set. Yes. Now I want you to go at your own pace. If the music is too fast or slow, do what feels good for you. Now both of them. Try it. If you prefer singles, singles it is. You get a little more rest break that way. Four more. Good. Three. Two. And take a break. Good. We're going to repeat this, but with a different grip. It's called an underhand grip. Ready? Right, left. Singles. Keep your elbows to the side. Don't force them in. We have a natural angle to our elbow, and we want to follow that. One more set like this. Go. You see how I'm straightening my arm all the way? Try it. Don't stop yourself halfway. Get the full range. Now doubles, here we go. Eight. Ooh, I lied, we have 12 of these. I'm lying to you right off the bat. Good. Now we have four more, good. Three, two, and one. Shake it out. Okay, the opposite muscle of biceps is triceps. You're gonna need one weight. This muscle right here.
It's a little bit weaker. We don't use it as often. It's smaller. We're gonna start with our elbow back and hinge forward. Now, kick back. Now, if you wanna put your hand on a chair, you could. These are our pushing muscles. We need them for things like vacuuming, mowing the grass, anything where we're pushing. Yes, three, two, and one. Good, stand up, stretch. Let's pass the torch. We're gonna do the other side. Ready, here we go. Now make sure you're not gripping tightly on the weights. Let that blood and oxygen flow to the muscles. Full range of motion. Maybe you could tuck your abdominals in a little bit here. Four more. Four. Three. Two, and one. Stand up tall. Let's pass the torch. I'm gonna give you another option. Arm above your head, down and up. I realize I'm not all the way in the screen, but you get the drift. I keep my hands here so I can feel the muscle working. It's also a reminder to me to keep my elbow up. How are you doing? Four more. Three, two, and one. Shake it out. Let's do the other side and then we'll move on. Ready? Arm up. Ready, down and up. Nice and slow so that we keep good form. Last four, go. Three, two, and one. Woo, grab your other weight. We're gonna move right into shoulders. I'd like to start with the front part of your shoulder, anterior deltoid. All right, nice and strong muscles. We're gonna do it by giving us a front raise. We'll start with an overhand grip. Raise the right and left. You'll notice I'm only going halfway up. That's on purpose. That way we don't impinge that shoulder joint. This is nice and safe. Another set. Good. Control. I have a little bit of a soft bend into my elbow. Not fully straight. Yeah. Now here comes our last set. Let's try both arms together. Go eight, seven, and then one more and relax. Good. Do you need water? Grab it if you do. I'll wait for you. Maybe you want to put your weights down and shake out your arms, whatever feels good. All right, we're going to move to the rotator cuff area. Deep, deep, deep shoulder muscles. This is important. Help prevent injuries in the rotator cuff. Hands, hammer grip, 90 degree angle. Now, we go out and in. You'll notice my elbows are in. I'm not pulling them out here. Isolate the rotator cuff muscles. Keep going. That's it. Are you starting to feel it? Give me four more. Three, two, and one. We're not done yet. I'm gonna give you it again, but a different hand grip, underhand grip. Ready, out and in. Nice. Control. Last four. Go. Three, two, and one. Good. Shake it off. Ooh, very nice, y'all. All right, let's move to the lateral deltoid. Medial deltoid. It's kind of the middle part of our shoulder, okay? Let's bring your hands in. We'll take the right arm out to the side. Now left. You'll notice I'm going halfway up again. Don't go all the way up. It's not good for that shoulder joint. Soft bend into the elbow. Another set. Now you can stay singles, but I would like for you to try both arms. Ready, last set. Go eight, seven, six. If you really need to bend your elbows, it makes it a little bit easier, decreasing the range of motion. One more, and good, yes. All right, shake it out. Shake it out, guys. Maybe you wanna put your weights down. Maybe you want some water, all right? You're doing great, you're doing great. I'm excited for you and your arms. It's gonna feel great. We're gonna go into some punches. This works shoulders and chest, all right? Your pec muscles. So you're gonna grab your weights. And we're gonna start with them right by your shoulders. And we punch. And we punch. Now, you can do all these in the sitting down position if you choose. Another set like this. One more. Good. I'm gonna switch the hand grip on you. Underhand grip, and we're gonna punch forward. Got it? Yeah. Here we go. Punch. Now, see how my arm is straight? I'm trying to really get it out there. Four more. And relax. All right. We have one more set of punches. You can do it. Two sets of eight. It's going to be crossing the body. Watch me. Cross. Look at my body, it's not moving, just my arms. Eight more. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and one. All right, you're doing amazing. We have two more that require weights. But for me, I'm gonna go lower on my weights. So I'm going down to my 3 pounds. So if you're already at 3 pounds, stick with them. But if you were at something heavier, maybe you wanna grab something lighter. These are called V-ups. They're for the shoulders. They're very functional. Because when we do things over our head, it's usually in this plane. It's not usually right in front of us, or it's not usually right out to the side. It's kind of in this area. Like when we reach up for cabinets, they're in that little plane, all right? So these are called V-ups. So we need to show our palms. Show me your palms. And we're gonna go up to the letter V. Ready? Here we go. Doing great. Two more sets of eight. Let's go. If you need to slow it down, go for it. Last set, you can do it. Go eight, seven. If it helps you, count down with me. Five. Four, come on. Three. One more. And rest. Good. All right. The last exercise with weights, I call them over-unders. Spill the milk, whatever you want to call them. I'm going to stick with my lighter weights here. And we're going to start with our arms out to the side, under hand grip. Go over, go under. Get those deep shoulder muscles rotating. Oh, these are killer. We have another set though. Go eight. Y'all, if you need to put your weights down, do it. And just continue with the motion. Nothing wrong with that. Eight more. I know, y'all. I don't want to do them either, but we got to. Come on. Think how great we'll feel afterwards. Six, five, four, three, two, and one. Oh my goodness. Woo! Do your arms feel like jelly yet? All right, let's finish with an exercise without weights. All you need is a wall. But if you have a countertop or a dresser or a big sturdy chair, that's going to be even better because we're going to be doing push-ups. The easiest way to get the chest muscles, all right? I'm going to be doing them on my wall, so you're going to see my better half, not so better half. So pick your place. Wall, chair, okay, dresser. Either way, the closer we are, the easier it's going to be. The farther are, the harder it's going to be. All right, so get your position. Arms out. Keep your back flat. And then we go down and up. Down and up. Here we go. 16. 15. Keep your back flat. It doesn't matter if your heels come up or down. That doesn't matter. Eight more. Eight. Seven. Four. Three. Two. And one. So hang tight with me. How did you do with day two? Day two, you're done with day two. Yay! All right, we really worked the arms, so we're gonna stretch the arms, all right? We're gonna start with a chest stretch, hands behind your body, and then from here, pull your shoulders back, chest is up, and head is up. Now, I don't recommend letting your head hang back. Those top vertebrae are just a little too delicate for our big bowling ball of a head to be hanging on it. So, just give it some space. Great. And now the opposite stretch. Interlock your fingers, stretch forward, and then chin down. Good. Now take your hands in, fingertips up, push in. Tilt your head to the left. All the way up. Opposite. Take the back of your hands against each other. Give it a little push. Tilt your head to the other side. Good. Now let's take our arms out. And now I want you to turn your hands, push up and back. This will stretch the biceps. And relax. One arm across your chest. Hold it in place. Give it a good pull. And then hold it. Now take your hand to your shoulder and push that arm. Reach for your shoulder blade and turn your head away from your hand. And then come out of it slowly. Other arm across your chest. Hold it. Hand on your shoulder, give it a good push, reach for your shoulder blade, turn your head. And last stretch, arm up, bend it behind you, hold it in place. This stretches your tricep. Ooh, that feels good. And then switch, other arm behind you. And then both arms up, reach up, inhale, and exhale. Give yourselves a big hand.
Woo, how'd we do? Did everybody survive? I hope that you enjoyed this workout. Please know how important strength training is. Especially as we age, we need the strength to be able to do functional everyday activities, and we need that weight bearing to keep our bones nice and strong so that we can help prevent falls and fractures. You did amazing. I'm so proud of you. Tune in tomorrow. I'm so excited for day three. It's going to be an amazing cardio workout.